एडिटोरियल वित्तीय ज्योति जर्नल ऑफ थियोलॉजिकल रिफ्लेक्शन रिटन बाय डॉक्टर पाउलोस पोप फ्रांसिस सिनेडालिटी एंड सिनेड 2023 द 16th ऑर्डिनरी जनरल असेंबली ऑफ द सिनेड ऑफ बिशप्स originally planned for October 2022 is now postponed by a year to October 2023. The theme of the synod is for a synodal church, communion, participation and mission. The church will begin the synodal process next month, which means that it will be a 2-year journey from October 2021 to October 2023. The origin of the Synod of Bishops goes back to a desire of the Second Vatican Council expressed in its document Lumen Gentium 21 November 1964 on the Church. The Council desired greater involvement of the bishops of the world in matters that concern the universal church. This desire is grounded on the understanding of the council that the bishops are not just pastors of their dioceses but also co-responsible with the Pope for the life and governance of the whole church. To realize this desire of the council, Paul VI established the new mechanism of the Synod of Bishops in the Church on 15th September 1965, a few weeks before the solemn ending of the Council on December 8th. A later document of the Council, Christus Dominus 28 October 1965, which dealt with the pastoral office of the bishops in the Church, explains the nature of the Synod of Bishops. Accordingly, the Synod of Bishops, consisting of bishops chosen from across the world and acting in the name of all the Catholic bishops, will assist the Pope in his ministry as the chief shepherd of Christ's flock. The Synod of Bishops symbolizes the pastoral solicitude of the entire Catholic Episcopate for the whole Church. There have been three kinds of synods after Vatican II: ordinary general assemblies, extraordinary general assemblies, and special particular assemblies. The ordinary general assemblies are a regular features of the Church occurring in every 3 or 4 years. The word general signifies the universal purpose and character of the synod. The words special and particular signify that the synod is concerned with the church in a particular country, region or continent. The extraordinary general assemblies are called by the Pope to address particular concerns of a universal nature but are out-of-turn assemblies apart from the ordinary general assemblies held regularly. In a ceremony commemorating the 50th anniversary of the institution of the Synod of Bishops held in Vatican on 17th October 2015, while the General Assembly of the 2015 Synod on the Family was in session, Pope Francis presented his views on synods and synodality. The Pope considers the Synod of Bishops as one of the most precious legacies of the Second Vatican Council. A synodal church is a church which listens, which realizes that listening is more than simply hearing. Evangelium Gaudium 171. It is a mutual listening in which everyone has something to learn. The faithful people, the College of Bishops, the Bishop of Rome, all listening to each other and all listening to the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Truth, John 14:17, in order to know what he says to the churches, Revelation 2:7. A synodal church means a church in which all of us, the Pope, bishops, clergy, religious and lay people, men and women, work together in all aspects of the church's life and mission. Etymologically too, the word synod implies a journeying together. In the thinking of the Pope, the journey is of the whole church, though the world's episcopate has an eminently authoritative role in it. For the Pope, the Synod of Bishops is the point of convergence of the dynamism of mutual listening in the Holy Spirit conducted at all levels of the life of the Church. In fact, he describes the Church as the journeying together of God's flock along the paths of history towards the encounter with Christ the Lord. He pointed out that it is preciously this path of synodality which God expects of the Church of the third millennium. The Pope grounded his understanding of synodality, which removes the bifurcation of the Church into Ecclesia Docens, the teaching church, and Ecclesia Discerns, the listening church, to the sensus fidei of the people of God. The sensus fidei prevents a rigid separation between an Ecclesia Discerns and an Ecclesia Discerns, since the flock likewise has an instinctive ability to discern the new ways that the Lord is revealing to the church. Pope Francis, Rio de Janeiro, 28 July 2013. The Pope wants the notion of synodality applied to all aspects of the life of the Church. For example, synodality in the area of evangelization would mean that all the baptized, whatever their position in the Church or their level of instinctive in the faith, are agents of evangelization, and it would be insufficient to envisage a plan of evangelization to be carried out by professionals while the rest of the faithful would simply be passive recipients. Evangelium Gaudium 1:20. The Indian Theological Association, which recently deliberated on the theme "The Church in India Today, Credibility and Witness," lays bare many failures and shortcomings in the life and structures of the Church, including its many personnel, particularly bishops, clergy and religious, which render it less credible as a true witness of Jesus and His Gospel. The Indian theologians believe that a synodal way of being church can go a long way in addressing the evils that mar the church's witness and credibility. They ask for a serious consideration on what it means to be a church, how it needs to be structured, the place and role of the laity, particularly women and others who are excluded from the church administrative roles and decision-making powers. They have an expansive understanding of the concept of synodality, including in its scope, sharing of power. The many crises confronting it today invite the church to face the issues in a non-defensive manner with a deep openness to the Spirit of God, making the very crisis a turning point for the Church's growth and revitalization. ITA Statement 2021, number 24. It is 55 years since the Council ended, which underlined the notion of the Church primarily as the people of God, replacing a pyramidal model of the Church, and yet in many aspects the Church has continued to function, in effect, in a pyramidal fashion. The Indian theologians appreciate Pope Francis' emphasis on the importance of synodality in the life of the Church and his many efforts in making the Church more and more a journeying together of all the faithful. They particularly list his constituting the Council of Cardinal Advisors with cardinals from different parts of the world to advise him on vital matters. His two synods on the family, 2014-2015, synod on the youth, 2018, and the special Amazonian synod, 2019, in which the bishops listen to married couples, youth, and the indigenous people respectively. With Pope Francis, the Indian theologians observe the ecclesia docens is also becoming as an ecclesia docens, ITA statement 2021 number 36. The synodal process has three parts. One, the preparatory phase in which the people of God are consulted on various aspects of the synodal theme. Second, the celebratory phase when the bishops chosen from across the world assemble with the Pope for mutual listening and deliberations. And third, the implementation phase, in which the conclusions of the synod, once approved by and as the guarantor of the obedience and the conformity of the Church to the will of God, to the gospel of Christ, and to the tradition of the Church, Pope Francis. The recently revised synodal process approved by Pope Francis aims at ensuring a fuller and active participation of the whole people of God in the synodal process. This is important for every synod, particularly for the next synod, which, as its theme for a synodal church shows, is a synod on the synodality itself of the Church. The preparatory phase of the Synod 2023 begins with the inaugural ceremonies led by Pope in Vatican on 9th to 10th October 2021 and by the diocesan bishops in their dioceses on 17th October 2021. The phase includes a 6-month diocesan phase, October 2021 to April 2022, and a 6-month continental phase, September 2022 to March 2023. Different national and international ecclesial bodies of bishops, religious and laity, as well as Catholic universities and theological faculties, besides the Synod Secretariat in Rome, will have their proper roles in the periods before, between, and after the diocesan and continental phases. We hope that we, the Church, will listen more reverently, attentively, receptively, and obediently to the Spirit of God speaking to us in the whole process of the Synod. Editorial, Vithya Jyothi, Journal of Theological Reflection, written by Dr. Paulos Mendoza.